Here we have Kenny and Minnow.
Yep, that's right. This is Minnow, the African Gray Parrot.
All right, now Minnow's been on before.
Yes, he has. He's been on a number of times.
Will Minnow perform for us before we talk a little bit about Minnow?
I think so.
Okay.
Minnow is a talking parrot, so he can do a lot of different things. It's not really talking, it's mimicking sound, and in the wild, mimics are very good for this parrot. But in captivity or in a zoo, we can train him to do lots of different things to have fun with the audience, but also provide educational messages. So we'll do a couple of his favorites. We'll see if he does this. Can you drop a bomb? Good boy. There's a little soft bomb there. We can see if we can do some of his other ones. He loves to do animal impressions. Minnow, can you do a kitty? Oh, you're a good kitty. What else we got in there? Can you do a monkey? There you go, monkey. And let's finish it up. Can you do a duck? You're a good duck. All right. And he even knows his name. So, what's your name? Oh, you're a good boy. Yep. He can tell a joke.
Oh.
Minnow, can you knock at the door? Can you knock at the door? Who is it? Are you funny? You are funny. What else do we have in here? Can you whistle a tune? Good boy. All right. What else can we do? I'm trying to think. It's been a while since I've done this whole routine. Oh, yeah. Can you do Indiana? Indiana. Oh, he's not going to do that one today. Minnow, can you give me a kiss? Oh, that was good. But he didn't sound too good. Let's see if he's okay. Minnow, are you sick? Minnow, are you sick? Do you have a cough? Oh, no. But you know what? I was sick last week, so let's see if he caught it from me.
Are you sick?
I am sick. Thank you for asking.
Wow.
And then when we're all done, we say bye. Can you say bye? Say bye.
See you later.
We'll see you later, too. Very good. So that's a little bit of Minnow's talking there for you.
Yeah.
So you said that helps him survive in the wild. How does that help him survive in the wild?
In the wild, he would mimic sounds of maybe predators, so he could scare other birds away from a food source, or he could scare another predator. So if he knew a sound of an owl or a different type of hawk, he could scare another owl or hawk away from him.
Oh.
So that would keep him safe. In captivity, he just picks up anything he says.
Wow.
Anything he hears or sees, so yes.
Very cool. Now, you know, I always like to point out if we see Minnow's leg has the band on it,
yep.
We could talk about the significance of that because that's a solid band.
Yep, and actually it's put on them when they're very, very young, and it says that they were born in captivity. And a problem with parrots is that for so long they were taken from the wild, and this did a really bad thing to their population. It just dropped the numbers down so much. So we try to advocate at the zoo to, if you're going to get a parrot as a pet, you know, get them from someone who's bred them in the wild, at their homes, not in the wild. This way we can assure that their populations will be there for a long, long time. So, yeah.
Very cool. And you know, I talk about their feet.
Oh yeah, he's got special feet. It's actually a special term. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you remember it from last time. Do you remember?
Nope, I don't.
It's called zygodactyl feet.
Okay.
And it means you have two toes in the front of your foot and two toes in the back. And it actually lets them hang upside down from branches to reach fruit that you might not be able to get otherwise.
All right, and now we always see that on woodpeckers also.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Very
absolutely.
Cool.
So yeah, that's Minnow there.
And so how does the tail also help them? I see that beautiful color red back there.
You know, they're not exactly sure. They think it might be a warning sign, so when they fly away, just flash that bright red tail. It's kind of like, whoa, what was that? Kind of startle a predator or something. When they do fly away in their flocks, you'll see that the tails all fan out, and you see a bunch of red. So it could be confusing to a predator. So,
yeah.
But, you know, it's beautiful on him. So.
Mm-hmm. Now, Minnow's eating Cheez-Its now, but he wouldn't get those in the wild, right?
Yes, they're just for training. I mean, at the zoo, we have a very balanced diet for him. But when he does come out and do programs and does his little cue, so you know, anytime I ask him to do something, he does it correctly. Like, give me a kiss. Good boy. We give him a Cheez-It as a reward, and it keeps it positive, and it builds trust between me and him. So he's willing to do these behaviors for me time and time again. But can't give him too many Cheez-Its.
All right. You know, well, thanks for bringing Minnow on, Kenny.
Thank you guys for having us.
All right.
We'll see you again soon.
Bye-bye.
Yep.